better word, is good. Read it right. Read works.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 75 of Let's Play Wall Street Raider. I'm RakeM, your host. The most astute of you who are watching this series may notice that something is a little bit off, and it's not your eyes, it's me. For the first time in over 130 videos on Wall Street Raider, I failed to save my game at the end of the last episode. So we're starting about 2 weeks shy of where we ended the last episode. When we ended the last one, it was around October 5th of 2031. We let all the banks declare their earnings, and where we are starting this one out is in the middle of September, right after I bought silver for Comcast and LGI. So we already have interest rate swaps set up for Bank of RakeM long swaps. But what we haven't done, and I went through the last episode to see what we missed, were all of these transactions. So Eli Lilly bought and sold calls on Sheenhan Bank, and then bought puts and sold calls on American General Insurance. He ran out of credit, so Lockheed Martin picked up where he left off. He then ran out of credit, and we had Cherry Automobile finish up. Then Provident contributed cash to Eli Lilly. We never actually did anything with that cash other than to pay off his debt. Then we had Hazama obtain some assets. And when I looked at that, I was like, why did I do that in the industry that we did, which was security services? Because that industry really isn't big enough to make a difference to Hazama. We need a much bigger industry, so we're not going to do that. We're also not going to liquidate Hazama or cancel interest rate swaps or any of this stuff that we did from that point on, except to sell off our corn, and that's if corn hits $6 a bushel. All right, so what we're going to be doing instead, we are going to go ahead and sell calls and buy puts on AGC and also some of these others if their price is above $5. We got to go double check and see if they are. So Mizuno, Westpac Bank, and Societe Generale, we're going to go check them real quick. I think they're all under $5, but if by chance one of them is above $5 a share, we will sell some options on it. Buy puts and sell calls. But otherwise, we're just going to continue on with AGC. He's not actually done. I did save my spreadsheet. I just didn't save my game. And I'm not sure if it was me or if maybe Windows did an update or something, but anyway, it was bound to happen sooner or later, and now it has happened. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and do these transactions. First of all, we're going to check on Mizuno. $4.72, so he's just under. Let's look at Societe Generale. 382, that's no good. And then what was the third one? Westpac Bank. Yeah, he's too low too. So we're just going to do American General Insurance. And it was Eli Lilly that's going to buy calls on Sheenhan Bank first, or sell calls on Sheenhan Bank first. We will go ahead and sell those calls, and then we'll start on AGC. I will fast forward and be right back. Eli Lilly has run out of credit, so now we're going to go over to Lockheed Martin. Sell the rest, or buy the rest of our puts, and then sell calls on AGC. All right, I had Lockheed Martin and Cherry Automobile both sell calls on AGC, and both of them ran out of credit. So we're going to have Oregon Steel do the same. and don't think there's very much left, so hopefully he can get the rest on this. Okay, well, we didn't get 100%, but I guess that's going to be good enough. So let's go to Provident. And we're going to give cash to Eli Lilly so that he can do some more options. So let's give him the 5275 that we did last time. And we will go ahead and pay off his loan. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to find another spot. Let's see, we got those two done. And when corn gets above 6, we'll sell it off, but we no longer really need this list. And for practical purposes, AGC is done. And we can't do the rest of these. Of course, we could do MGM if we want to do 2% at a time. He's worth a lot in terms of his stock price. 2% would be $200 billion apiece. And he's losing a lot of money. $41 he's going to lose. And he's got a premium. So let's have Eli Lilly sell this one short. We'll have him buy puts. It's only going to be 2% at a time, so this is going to take a minute, and I'll fast forward while I do so. All right, I'm not quite done buying options here, but gold has gotten all the way down to 1050. Going to interrupt what we're doing and buy gold for all of our holding companies. If silver falls back below 15, we'll buy some more of it too. So let's go to peak. Look at that, dropped all the way. So I'm going to buy some gold for everybody. I will fast forward and be right back. We got gold for everybody, but silver, we came close. We didn't get it quite for everybody, but we got close. And we need to go over to the bank and sell off some mortgages, I'm sure. Because he's out of money. Let's sell off $6 trillion. And let's see, is there anything else we need to do? I guess with this falling, I guess not. Which is good, because that's going to help our swaps out. Let's hope it goes below 10. All right, so we're done with makeup, except for selling corn. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete this, because we know to sell corn. Right, and we're pretty much done with these as well. So now it's just a matter of maximizing our profits at Provident. Right now, with the industry or the market as a whole being in such bad shape, there's not much that we can do except to wait for these to turn around, you know, for the GDP growth and prime rate to turn around, which they are in the process of doing that now. But in the meantime, we got a lot of companies that are going broke because they have too much debt. So what we can do is we can look for stocks, doesn't matter what they're trading at, that are, let's see, let's go with between 10 billion and say 60 billion. There's 76 of those with credit of D or better. I don't want to limit my returns based on the credit rating, but I want it to show me the credit rating in the results, right? Because what I want to do is I want to go to the D-rated companies, or not the D-rated, but the C, anything that's C. So C, CC, or CCC. I want to look at them and see if we can sell it short. So GE's the first one here. He's going to lose 40% of his net worth in the next quarter. That's his projection. All right, so we could sell him short. He's above $10 a share or $5 a share, right? But all of our sub companies, all the companies underneath Provident are out of cash. So we have to do this with Hazama. Right, and he's got credit to do it with. So what we're going to do is we're going to buy puts on GE. All right, I will fast forward while I buy these and I'll be right back. All right, that's all the options for GE. Let's look and see who's next on the list. All right, so Honda Motor Company. He's negative on his return overall. This industry is improving though, but his credit is terrible and he's projected to lose 10% by his stock price. And he's underpriced, so he's been losing and he's still losing, but the industry is improving. Now we could throw a wrench into this by growing here, right? So I could have Toyota grow. So if we grew here, let's see, we would have to grow at, I think, about 20%. To make up for all this downsizing, maybe a little bit more. See, just for his, we'd have to grow at 20%. So then we'd have to grow a little bit more for these. No, I guess that's about right. Somewhere between 20 and 25 we'd have to grow at for him to for this industry to remain deteriorating. So we could do that, and it would also offset the increase in returns from these guys going broke. Wow, look at Kia. He's got a nice premium on his. All right, so I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and sell this stock short. And if it starts to turn around, we will up our growth rate to make sure that he stays negative. I mean, he's paying 7.75 on this, and on his bank loan he's paying 18.5. So his assets would have to make something like 12%. He'd have to get a return on investment of about 12% to cover just his debt, and he's at a negative 3% right now. So I think we're okay to do these. All right, so I'm going to buy puts and sell calls on Honda, and I will be right back. All right, real quickly, let's get silver for these other two companies. Our banks are declaring and they should all be up. They were last time. Reuters has been put on the market, but we're only passively investing in Reuters, so we are not interested. There's Shanghai, he's good. Let's go to Facebook and get silver. It's too bad we didn't buy oil, but it never really got low enough. And corn is ready to sell, which I should have on my spreadsheet, but I don't. Everybody has corn. So let's go sell off all of our corn. I will fast forward and be right back. When Bank of RakeM declares, we're gonna go check on all of CMGI's stock options and review what those companies are projected to make in the next quarter now that their interest rate swaps have expired. All right, we've sold off all of our corn, and with the interest rate down and the GDP going up, I want to go ahead and get some index futures for Provident. We're going to buy some long index futures and see if we can boost our earnings by getting some income off of there. Now, I don't want to go crazy. I just want anywhere from 200 to 400 contracts. It just depends on what we can get from counterparties that are out in the market. $58,000 is what they want for a 5-year contract, which is pretty high. Let's just try 100. We've got to borrow to do this. All right, since we have to borrow, I'm going to stop there. Right, and now we're going to go to Eli Lilly and have him buy some more options. But first, let's go over to CMGI and check on, well, they're not done declaring. Not done declaring. So let's go to our list and see who to do next. So next up is JP Morgan Bank, but we've already done him. So PepsiCo is next. And he's actually making a profit. His bonds are at 8%. He's got all that cash. So that's not a good choice. So let's go back to Lilly and then to our list. There's Pepsi. And that's it. That's all the C-rated companies. I guess between 10 billion and 60 billion, that's all there is. We didn't do ABN AMRO. Let's check him. All right, so he's gonna lose 10% of his value. He's got a lot of cash, but very little equity, and he's trading at a premium. And most of his money is in mortgages. He's paying out a lot of money on these deposits. Being that he has a premium, I'm inclined to go ahead and do it. So let's have Eli Lilly buy puts and sell calls on ABN AMRO. I will fast forward and be right back. Eli Lilly ran out of credit before he got 100% of the call sold, but that's fine. And Bank of RakeM declared his earnings. They were way up like they were last time. And as soon as he declared, we had a rally on the stock index, which should help out Provident. He's making $10 billion already off of those. So we can pay off our loan. That should help him when it comes time for him to declare. So let's go to CMGI. His options are now up to $53 billion in value. So what we want to do is we want to look at the banks that we sold short and see what their projections are for next quarter. So BESF, losing a whole bunch of money. He's only worth $300 million now and has a huge premium, so that should come way down. So we're looking good to hold those. Next up is JPMorgan Chase. He's down to $700 million in value. Right, so that looks good to hold. He's gonna lose a bunch of money again. So we can hold that one and wait for it to go broke. National Bank of Greece, his price is finally coming down. He's scheduled to lose $10 a share. He's only worth $11 billion and his price has come up, well, I guess his net worth has come down to meet his stock price. But he's still on the way down. Let's see, if he loses $10 a share and he has $100 million, that's $1 billion he's gonna lose. $1 billion, so he'll come down to $10 billion or so. So I guess we can hold on to it for now. Next one is Shinhan Bank. He's going to lose $1 a share, which is going to be $3 billion. Another 10% of his net worth he's going to lose. So we're good to hold on to him as well. And I think that does it for him. Let's go over to Eli Lilly. Lockheed Martin, and we'll check on the ones they have. So American General Insurance has not declared yet. He declares in one day. Let's go ahead and have him, let's forward the ticker to his declaration. Right, here's Mitsui. And now American General lost 73 cents. Aetna, his earnings are down, but he's positive. And now American General is projected to make a profit in the coming quarter because he no longer has swaps. Unless he had a new one with the bank. I guess he did. But he shouldn't be projecting a loss. He should be projecting a profit. Let's take a look at his swaps. Okay, let's go to, I guess, Bank of RakeM. So we're looking for American General Insurance over here. There he is. He's got one based on the short bond. Oh, his doesn't. Well. Oh. So he's got one more quarter. So I guess on December 30th, he's got to do this one too. They haven't expired yet. Okay. So that's going to help. That's good. And then our next set doesn't start until the second quarter of next year, which would be, what, June? All right, so AGC is gonna lose $1 billion on the swap, but yet he's still positive over here. Still has a premium because his earnings were up for the year, which seems kind of weird. Got most of his money in bonds and then some in stock. Let's go over to Eli Lilly and see whether or not he can take a profit on those right now. Provident way up. Progressive is up. Okay, so if we sell these off now, we can make a profit. All right, so we would buy these back and we would take a profit on them. Which since we have some more on that list that we can invest in, let's do that. Because if his income goes up again, our profit will go away. So let's go ahead and sell or buy these back. So we've sold off all of our options on American General Insurance, and every one of them made a profit except for Oregon Steel. I think he broke even, maybe was a small loss. Lost $30 million because AGC's price went up as we were selling them off. Selling them off and buying them back. So you keep an eye on this. I'd like to buy some more oil. All right, so all of our insurance companies now have declared as well. RakeM Insurance, his earnings were up, I believe. Yep, a little bit. At 3.5 in regular income, 3.5 trillion. And his projection for next quarter is 32 cents, which is lower than it's been. That's because, I think, because the prime rate's going down. But we'll see. Let's give $2 trillion to the bank. Okay, and let's put $2 trillion into mortgages. All right, so I think if there's anything else we need to do, I think that's it for now. So let's go back to CMGI and continue looking at the options. I think we checked everybody out here, except for AGC, which we're done with. So now let's go through the rest of our companies. Lockheed Martin doesn't have any left. So we could buy some new ones from our database search. But first, let's check out these others. Cherry Automobile doesn't have any. Eli Lilly. All right, ABN AMRO and Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer. So let's check these out. Looks like his stock price is up. Right, so he lost $4.87. And he's projected to lose $2 more. And the stock price is stable despite the fact that he's still losing money. He's got no cash and no stocks. All he has is mortgages. And he has an interbank loan. So I guess he had like $180 billion here and a $600 billion outlay. and now they've both come down by 180 billion. So somebody that banks with him must have spent $180 billion. Which, as far as I know, we're the only ones in the game that spend that kind of money. All right, let's go back to Lily. Let's look at Metro Goldwyn Mayer. He's slated to lose $30 a share. And he's rated D, which means he must be negative now, and he is. So we can hang on to him and let him go broke. Then he also has some Shinhan Bank options, call options that he sold, and we're making money on those. So ABN AMRO is the only one that's really in danger here. These others we're going to make a profit on. All right, and now let's look at Oregon Steel. He doesn't have anything. Okay, good. All right, so let's go to Lockheed Martin. Bring up our search results. Look for some C-rated companies. General Electric, we've already done. Honda, we've done. JP Morgan Chase, we've done. PepsiCo, we looked at, and he's not in terrible enough shape. All right, so now United Health is showing up. He's got cash and bonds and a little bit of assets. Big premium. But he's making money. He's making 1% per quarter. And this is improving. But he's got a negative return. So how could he be making money? I guess because he's only got $1 billion in assets. So he's losing money but on his assets. But he's got so much cash that he's making a profit. So let's pass on him and take a look at the one that was down the bottom. Westpac Bank, but he is trading too low. So let's revise our database search from 10 to 60 and make this 5 to 10. That gives us 62. So let's look at Alliance. He's supposed to make a profit. He made $20 a share last year. He's got a premium and he's supposed to make a profit. So that's no good. This one we've already got. AG Edwards. Huge negative here. Got a premium. And when you take that $7 billion and you put it down here, he's going to have more debt than equity. Losing $435 million, and he's only worth, let's see, he's got $100 million. That's probably his whole thing. Right, $475 million. That'd be $47.50 a share. Let's sell him short real quick. So let's go to Lockheed Martin and we'll buy puts and sell calls. While I was buying those options, we got a notice that Provident had a margin call because he was losing money on his index futures, which is kind of not good. We need him to increase in value, not decrease. But what happened was is our interest rate shot up from 11%, 11 and change, all the way back up to 13. And as a result, the Cotango on the on the index dropped in a hurry. And so we lost something like $30 billion, which is absolutely horrible. I mean, the value on our stocks is way, way up, thanks to CMGI making money on, all of our companies making money on options, but that is not good. That is a tremendous problem, right? So if we look at the futures, the current value is $46 billion based on the original 58. And if the Cotango now is down even with the stock index, that'll keep going down if this stays high. That's good for our options, but bad for these futures. So I'm thinking we might have to go ahead and close these out if this is going to stay up. But I really don't know what's the best thing to do. If we should go ahead and cover them now and take the additional loss, or if we should hang on to this. Price on the insurance company is headed down too. He was up to 34 a little while ago. Now they've got him rated to sell. So just not sure. Zama continues to go up. His options are continuing to grow. His stock price hasn't caught up yet. Look at that. We have more than, we have done very well here. We've got what? Started with 13 billion and we're up to 100. Our income is terrible, but our equity is fantastic. Look at that stock price. It hasn't caught up with his equity either. So options on Hazama are huge. We're way up on Provident as well. Provident is actually trading at his net worth. Wonder if we should buy more. Let's see what it's going to cost. Do we have any credit at all? Okay, so we've got some credit to work with. Problem is if it goes down some more, we're going to be in a world of hurt. So I think we'll just stick with what we got. So let's look and see if there's anybody else that we want to buy options on. The next one would be Jaguar. He was actually on our list, but he's only 1% public. So let's skip him and go and look at the next one, is going to be NBC. He's at $7.35 a share, so we can sell options on him. He's underpriced though. He's worth $9.5 billion, trading at $7.5, and he's going to lose another $1.91. And he's grossly incompetent. The industry is improving, but not by much. And look at that, negative 19. Yeah, let's sell him short. Okay, so let's see. Lockheed Martin got 100% puts and 100% calls on AG Edwards. So he should have some credit left. So let's have him sell calls and buy puts on NBC. We've been ignoring bankruptcies for a while and they're starting to pile up, so let's clear these out real quick. This first couple are from the defense industry, Thales Company and Cordant Technologies. And ordinarily we would just merge them in with Lockheed Martin. But I'm going to do something a little bit different. We want Lockheed Martin's return to stay high. And with these being lower, what we're going to do is we're going to have Lockheed Martin buy assets from Rolls-Royce Aero, and then we'll have Rolls-Royce Aero merge these two in. All right, we don't have to worry about monopoly status with United Technologies up here above us. So that's the direction we're going to go. So let's have Lockheed Martin buy $1 billion in assets from Rolls-Royce Aero. It didn't really hurt or help our return any, but we do have another $1 billion in assets here. So now we'll have Rolls-Royce Aero buy Cordant Technologies and Thales Compania from the bank. That's $750 million in assets. And just out of curiosity, what's this tax loss carryover? $1.5 billion. And then the other one. He's over at US Bank Corp, and it's another $700. Eli Lilly lost a little bit of money. That's interesting. Of course, he was scheduled to lose anyway, so. But it's better than the 60 cents he was scheduled to lose. Let's go back over to the bank and see what those other two were. Of course, it's three now. Let's take a look at Air Canada. Trading at a premium, so we could sell him off, especially considering he's negative. This industry isn't really improving. So let's just get rid of this one, unless he has a lot of tax loss carryovers. Ooh, $6 billion. Well, that's kind of worth keeping. Yeah, 45%. He's a 1% share. And we've got not quite 10 going broke. So if we take him, it's going to put us awful close to being monopolies when these go broke. Let's see, this is 4%, 6.5%. So 7%. And we would have 46.2. It's awful close. It'd give us like 49.7 once everybody goes broke. Let's go ahead and sell them off for now. It'll likely go broke again and have a smaller market share at that point, so we can think about keeping him then. Genesco is in footwear. We have LGI there. I thought we did. Oh, he's bookstores. All right, we don't have anything here. Slightly improving and a lot of people going broke. Let's take a look at some of these. Okay, this one's wholly owned. These are pretty small. Let's get rid of it. And we need to buy wheat. And we can go ahead and buy oil, and we can sell off our silver and gold if we want. All right, let's sell off Genesco. And let's take a look at Georgia Paper. He's way down here. Huge premium. A lot more people going broke. Yeah, let's sell him off. All right, let's buy wheat, let's buy oil. And look at that, it went way down. And let's do some swaps for Provident too. Let's do Provident swaps first. Well, actually, these commodity prices will change faster than the interest rate will. Let's buy our wheat and our oil first. Okay, it's oil has gotten too high, wheat has gotten too high, silver and gold looked like they were going to get up there and then they've dropped. So we're going to stop where we are. Let's look at Provident. His index futures are back up. Of course, he's still losing money, but they're up from where they were. We're going to pay down the loan. And the thing is, the interest rate has fallen to 13. We're going to take a look and see what kind of offer we will get on some swaps here. So we want long position based on the prime rate. And we're going to lower this down to 50 billion as the nominal amount. We're going to start in the third quarter of 2032. Finish in the first quarter of 2037. 10.3%. All right, so as long as the prime rate goes down between now and the third quarter, this is on Morgan Stanley, which we don't want. We want this to be with banks. Iberia Bank we can do. I think this is a securities company, but we'll go and look it up before we accept this one. Bank of Ireland. Standard Life. Webster Financial. So let's look up Webster Financial and that other one. Okay, so he's a bank. And then the other one began with a B. Right here, Banco. Okay, I guess he's a bank. Yeah, he's a bank. All right, let's try to get those two. Lower our nominal amount to 30 billion. All right, I guess we've got all the banks we're gonna get. So let's take a look at our swaps. How many did we get? Okay, that's 9. That's not bad. And it looks like our swaps are back to losing money again. All right, let's just check and see if any of our companies have a big market share that needs to be addressed. So Komatsu does. It's got 54%. Let's buy up Agco and give him 15% of our assets. All right, so he's back down underneath where he needs to be. Let's see if there's any others. All right, Resorts International. Got too big a market share here. Let's pick up Deltona. And again, we're going to give him 15% of our assets. So I guess $12.50. He's losing money, so let's sell it. And U.S. Homes is losing money, so let's sell that too. All right, this is a bond reorganization. I'm just going to say no. And our market share is back down to 46. So let's see if anybody else is in violation here. NVIDIA is at 48. And then Lucky Gold Star is at 48. And so is Ford. So let's check and see if any of these are in danger. And I'd say he is. We just got Glatfelter. We'll look at him in a minute. So here he's losing all kinds of money on his assets. He has no cash or other investments. So we definitely need to downsize here. He is a 32% market share, so we'd have to get rid of at least 15% of our market share, which is a third of our assets. So let's pick up this one right here, Linear Technologies, and we'll give him, let's see, we're going to give him $40 billion. Now we've got 29%. And he's making a profit, so we'll keep that 19% at NVIDIA and just have TMFI sell off the 81. Okay, so let's look at Lucky Gold Star. Got these two down here going broke. We don't really have to worry about it. Dow is above us. He's got good credit. So we're okay there. And that leaves Ford, who is now going down in market share. GM's going to go broke again, possibly. He is losing money, has very little equity, huge premium. We need to sell options on him. Need to sell him short, and then we need to downsize. So let's go to Hazama and sell calls and buy puts on GM. And then we'll go downsize Ford, and from there we'll just call this an episode. Now that GE is sold short, let's go over to Ford and downsize him a little bit. So we're expecting this 17% to be removed from the industry, as well as this 0.7%. So we need to downsize by 9% of our market share, which is 20% of our assets. So we are going to grab, wow, look at his price, 8,000% above value. How ridiculous is that? And he's going broke. He's got all these stocks. And he's going broke. If he was worth more money, I would say let's sell him short, but he's so small. Let's see. 20% of our assets is going to be $7 billion. And he's really the only option. We have to pay $500 million to get him. It's going to cost us more than that if we become a monopoly, so let's go ahead and do it. Okay, we can't buy him because of antitrust reasons. So let's find ourselves a holding company. Falcon Bridge, maybe. He's 100% public. He does have stock, though. So let's look for another one. Trump Hotels has stock as well. So does Biogen. All right, Reliance has stock, but he doesn't control it. And it's Alibaba, which is down here, a 1% market share. So even if he did, it wouldn't bother us. So let's get Reliance. And then give him some assets. He's going to lose his tax loss carryovers, but we don't care. So this is going to cost us $400 million. And now we'll give him $7 billion in assets. Spin off 81%. Okay, now he's scheduled to lose money. We're scheduled to make money. And his return is positive, so he shouldn't lose money, really. Not in the long run, especially with the industry improving. I think what we'll do is we'll spin off 81%, keep the rest. We're going to keep this, and if it continues to show a negative when his projection gets revised, we'll go ahead and sell it off then. Okay. Let's see, what's our sale price on wheat? Wheat is $7. So stock price over at RakeM Insurance is down, and I'm just going to go check on Provident, and then we'll call this an episode. Just want to see how he's doing on his futures since the index is down another 4,000 points. So even though the current stock index is down, the Cotango is up. We'd take a loss if we sold it off right now, but let's pay down our loan. So our value here is really climbing. Let's take a look at CMGI. He's up to 116 billion, 115 billion. Stock price still hasn't caught up. And at Azama, we're up to 118 billion and stock price hasn't caught up. So we're heading in the right direction on these, and hopefully when Provident recovers, and also hopefully when he makes money off swaps, hopefully this will really go through the roof. So we're up to 111, 118, what was it? All right, so based on the stock price, we're up to 74, which is from 28, we're almost at 300%. A long ways to go yet. But anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and share. And until next time, this is RakeM saying, have a good one.